Now, as industries continue to struggle to keep pace with the ever-present decarbonisation initiatives, we've seen some interesting tactics. Well, add this one to your list. Giant kites. At the start of next year, Ville de Bordeaux, which sounds like a nice wine, but it's actually a 154-metre-long ship that moves air part components, will unfurl a 500-square-metre kite on journeys across the Atlantic Ocean. Joining me now to discuss this evening and plenty of other topics is the Vice President of the Federal Liberal Party, Tina McQueen, and former Labor Senator, now Sky contributor, Stephen Conroy. How are we, team?
Well, thanks, Caleb. Very well.
Very good. Merry Christmas to both of you. How are you?
Good.
Good to hear. Thank you very much. Now, Tina, have they just gone and invented the sailboat? I mean, for heaven's sake, if they wanted this sort of, you know, carbon-neutral way of moving things around on the ocean, it's existed for hundreds of years. It'll be bizarre seeing these things floating around with these massive kites off them, won't it?
Caleb, we've gone back to where we began. I mean, all these advances in technology and motors and magnificent vessels, we're literally going back to where we started. It's insane. There's no end to this rubbish, Caleb. There really isn't. And what if there's, a number of ships all trying to... And I forget that... I know it's quite big. I forget exactly, but it's going to be massive. It's just lunacy. Everyone's looking to make a buck on this, Caleb. I think that's what the story is.
Well, we'll have to go back to horse and cart soon. I mean, you know, yes. All these minerals and stuff we've got to mine out of the ground to make the batteries and these electric cars surely can't be good. Stephen, are you looking forward to seeing one of these weird, massive kites floating past on the beach?
Well, look, when you first sent through the article earlier on today, I thought it was April Fool's Day. So that was my first reaction. But look, I fortunately live near Williamstown Beach, and on the really windy days, we have a kite surfers that race up and down the beach. So I know exactly what you mean when you say you're looking forward to seeing these cargo ships. But look, if they think it will work, if they think it will save fuel and save carbon pollution, then look, good luck to them. I'm a bit with Tina there. I can't wait to see them trying to navigate. I think they're a bit slower to navigate than those kite surfers. And they managed to go pretty close to hitting each other, but could be a little bit trickier with turning around the Titanic, as they say.